Sunlight, sky, trees, wind, nature. Sounds, music, movements, expressions. Street, people on the street, people walking by, people laughing with each other. Travels, experiences of all kinds, meeting, seeing, hearing, touching. All of these things I experience ruminate in my mind and make little connections and clicks that bring out new ideas and new ways to approach this profession that I've been working in for so many years. I started directing when I was 12, and now about 250 plays later, I still go through the same process of looking for inspiration once again each time I do something new.
When we want to listen to the stories of others, we go to a theater. This handsome silver-haired man, who is surrounded by a crowd, tells interesting stories of the lives led by all kinds of people in this world. He is Robert Johanson, a musical director and a virtuoso. The list of his major works goes on and on. Dynamic and glamorous, each and every one of them tugs at the heartstrings of the audience. It was 10 years ago that Robert, who at the time was enjoying his prime as a Broadway musical director, formed a special bond with Korea. Impressed by the performance of Korean actors, he now visits every year to stage a musical. Knowing his passion, many wish to work with him. It's no different for Kim Ju-won, the world-famous ballerina who is starring in the musical Phantom.
Musical Phantom이라는 작품의 벨라도바 역할을 로버트 연출님이랑 하게 되면서 상당히 많은 도움을 받았어요. 춤 그리고 발레라는 장르에 대해서도 아주 전문가보다 더 많은 디렉션을 줄 수 있을 정도로 기능적인 부분도 그렇지만 아무래도 언어가 없이 저희는 몸으로 이야기를 풀어야 되니까 감정적인 부분에 대해서 상당히 많이 얘기를 나누는 편이에요. 좀 더 드라마적인 디테일에 좀 신경을 많이 써볼 수 있도록 그렇게 만들어 주시는 것 같아요.
His musicals have a rule.
The projects that I'm interested in doing are projects that will move people and touch them. You know, I want the people to carry away a feeling that that will stay with them. So when I decide to do a show, it's because it has touched me. It's something in it that I feel very tender about, and I want to be sure I can bring that across to the audience.
This winter, he is staging two musicals. Seeking inspiration for something new, he decides to go on a trip. Robert heads to Yeongju, Gyeongsangbuk-do province. Home to nature in its pristine, unspoiled state, the city is filled with warm sunlight and bracing air. It's also home to Sosu Sawon, a Confucian academy that makes its visitors gaze in reverence. Consisting of tile-roofed houses, it was where students used to study in the past. They were called Yusang, meaning students of Confucianism, or Sunbi, meaning scholars.
이 직방제라고 하는 것은 교수님이나 뭐 총장님이 기거했던 곳이고 저기 칠학제 학구제는 그 우리 유생들이 여기 학생들이 기거했던 장소라고 보면 돼요. 그래서 선생님의 집을 보면 지붕이 더 높게 지어졌고 유생들의 집은 더 낮게 지어놨어요. 이렇게 선생님과 층을 뒀다는 얘기죠. 그래서 문도 비교를 해보시면 선생님은 별로 숙이지 않고 들어가도 되지만 유생들이 문은 작게 만들어서 어릴 때부터 겸손함을 가르치는 거예요. 영주시 위도가 그 36.5도예요. 그래서 태양이 많이 비쳐서 여기는 사과도 맛있고 인삼도 잘 되고 여기는 굉장히 좋은 곳이에요. 그래서 조선시대 때 보면 정감록에 나오는 가장 살기 좋은 곳 우리 조선 전체에서 열 군데를 정해놨는데 풍기라는 곳이 첫 번째 살기 좋은 곳이에요. 그래서 여기는 귀촌하는 분들이 많이 오고 이런 곳이에요, 영주시는.
A pleasant walk around the venue reminds Robert of his first visit to Korea.
I really, really have appreciated being here. About 10 years ago, I was invited to come to Korea to direct Hamlet. At that time, I didn't know anything about Korea. I was totally in the dark. I had never been to Asia. So it was my first experience in Asia and in Korea. And my eyes were completely open to a whole different world from what I was used to. And now I've been coming here regularly for 10 years. And I feel it's my second home. I feel I have two lives. I have my life, my 6 months in Korea, my 6 months in America, and they're two very different and exciting and wonderful lives. At this point in my time, as I'm older, it's quite exciting to be able to have found something completely new and thrilling. So when I visit places like this, when I go to these, see Korea, not only the work I do here, but going around and seeing the culture and the people, I feel somehow that I've become a real part of it. You know, I'm not Korean, but I feel very much in tune with so many of the thinkings and feelings of Korean people.
As if it has gone back in time 500 years, Sosu Sawon is enveloped in a serene, warm glow. This picturesque scene of autumn would probably have been the same then. Robert takes a leisurely stroll, fully feeling the season. There is actually a reason why Robert came to Yeongju today. He's here to watch a traditional madangnori performance, which will be held in the large court. Prior to the actual performance, the actors, dressed in hanbok, are engrossed in their rehearsal.
Thank you. Thank you so much. This is great fun. I'm making you cry. This style of performing, the way that you perform, is sort of out of a folk tradition. It's like having fun with it, making the audience laugh, but then also touching them with the story. Is that the way it's set up?
그래요, 맞아요. 마당놀이라는 그 형태가 금방 얘기하신 대로 관객과 주고받는 호흡 이런 것들을 되게 중요시하고 해악도 있고 웃음도 있고 또 약간의 슬픔도 있고 하는 것들 다 전달합니다. 희노애락 네 가지를 다 전달해요.
그리고 이 마당이라는 공간적인 게 무대에 국한되지 않고 갇혀 있지 않기 때문에 그야말로 열려 있는 공간이다 보니까 배우와 관객이 정말 그 눈앞에서 바로 같이 느끼고 울고 웃고 서로 같이 공감하고 그래서 아마 관객들이 더 좋아하시는 것 같아요. 그리고 저희 이 공연이 이제 내년에는 중국 혹은 아시아권의 다른 나라 공연도 좀 계획이 되어 있습니다.
I think both in Japan and China that they're very fascinated by Korean performing. They're very fascinated by singing, by dancing, and by the dramas now. I mean, it's been opened up to them. I think theater is more popular from the Korean perspective than anywhere else. Many, many Japanese and Chinese people come to Korea to see these things. Yeah. Is it because Korea has the very best actors? Is that why? I think so. I'm really looking forward to seeing your performance today. This will be my first time seeing this type of style in Korea, and I'm really excited to see it. Okay, I want to ask you to sing something for us. Would you like to do that?
Yes.
All right, get ready. Fighting! Fighting! Okay!
내 판자가 사는 대로 내 시세가 닿는 대로 마음 심자 제일이라 단단하게 맘 잡으면 세상만사 모든 일이 이 안이 행복할까 준삼월 오시절에 화장놀이 왔거들랑 좋은 동무 좋은 놀이 서로 웃고 놀아보세 서로 웃고 놀아보세
마당놀이는 어떻게 보면 우리나라의 전통 뮤지컬이라고 볼 수 있거든요. 그래서 가무, 악, 극이 다 들어가 있는 이런 장르라고 볼 수 있는데 우리가 이제 무용을 하고 춤을 추고 또 노래를 하다 보면 관객들의 이 반응에 따라서 애드립이 얼마든지 가능하고요. 어떤 그 지역성을 또 그때그때마다 또 우리 배우들이 또 소개를 해줄 수 있고 또 함께하는 그러한 분위기를 또 연출해낼 수 있는 게 가장 큰 특징이라고 볼 수 있을 것 같습니다.
마당놀이 has no fancy stage or VIP seats. The audience members sit wherever they want to, watch the performance, and soon get immersed in it.
I really enjoyed seeing the performance this afternoon because it reminded me of the origins of theater. Theater started as street theater. People would perform in their town square, or they would travel around the countryside and perform anywhere they could find an audience. And the same techniques that they use to engage the audience, to make them laugh, to get them to feel something, are the same things I saw today. And it's wonderful to see these traditions being upheld in the theater here in Korea.
The next day, Robert is on his way to learn about the beginnings of Korea's modern musicals. He finds himself on Daehangno Street, a street of culture and art. Just 2 kilometers long, it is home to hundreds of theaters. Robert has an appointment here with this beautiful lady.
Hi, good to see you.
She is Kim So-hyun, Korea's top musical actor. She has already made her debut in Broadway.
Oh my god.
I'm so excited.
Me too. So you're going to be my guide through this area?
I'd love to.
I've been here before, but of course there are over 200 theaters.
There are lots of theaters, small theaters.
I know. It's exciting. I mean, just walking around here, there's so many young people, there's so much activity, great restaurants.
People, right?
It's a great area.
Great area.
Yeah.
I was born here.
Yeah,
I grew up here.
Right here?
Yeah, like near there.
Right over there?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
How great for you.
I love here. This is my favorite
So your parents got to see you right here in this theater.
Mm-hmm.
That's nice.
So you want to go with me?
All right, let's do it.
Okay, let's
Show
do
me
it.
Around.
Yeah,
okay.
Sure. I'd love to.
Good, thanks so much.
Both those who wish to become actors and veteran actors who wish to go back to the basics meet on Daehangno Street. So-young will introduce Robert to the place where she herself began her career. In order to do that, there is a musical that she must show him. Love is in the Rain, or Sabita, is Korea's representative original musical that has been staged in Daehangno for more than two decades. During its over 4,000 shows, hundreds of actors have come and gone. The theater itself may be small, but its history and memories rival those of any large theaters.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Hello. Hello.
저는 김서양이라는 배우고요. 여긴 로버트 연출님이세요.
Nice to meet you.
안녕하세요.
Happy to be here, really.
Yeah.
She's told me a lot about the show because she was in the show many years ago.
네. 제가 얘기를 많이 했어요. 왜냐면 제가 이 쇼에 했었기 때문에 제가 유미리를
I played this role like 2000 6 and 8 and 11.
Oh, wow.
Like three times.
Oh, you kept coming back.
Yeah.
Yeah, you need to come back
so
to it.
I'm so excited to be here.
Uh-huh. Do you have like a favorite number that you remember from the show that you can sing a little bit together?
Oh. 우리 같이 셋이 함께 하는 게 뭐가 있죠? 사랑.
사랑. 맨 마지막으로.
그렇죠?
네. 맞습니다.
네. 두려움만 가득한 알 수 없던 나의 모습 인증가 날 날게 되리 아무도 모르게
어느덧 세월 많이 흘러
알 수 없던 나의 모습 난
지난 날 그 자리 철없던 그 시절
돌이켜 생각해보네 이제야 알 것만 같아 그건 바로 사랑이야 일곱 빛깔 무지개가 눈앞에 보이네
한번 해도 될까요?
Can I play tonight?
Yeah.
Oh, that's wonderful. You sound great together. You should make another group. Go on television.
Oh. Oh.
So-hyun의 매력이라고 보면은 베이지 관객들하고 되게 가까이 호흡할 수 있고 관객들을 되게 가까이서 볼 수 있으니까 연기를 하면서 아, 저 관객들이 시시각각 변하는 그런 모습들 그런 표정들 그런 감정들을 더 받으면 어떤 부분에서는 더 배가 될 때가 있고 어떤 부분에서는 좀 아, 내가 너무 심하게 했나? 이제 그런 것도 있고 이제 그런 재미를 할 수 있는 그런 게 좀 있어서 저는 되게 즐겁습니다.
아, 네.
저는 아무래도 오빠 말씀하신 것처럼 가까이 계시다 보니까 그래서 좀 마음가짐이 매번 또 새롭게 다지고 들어가게 되는 것 같아요.
저는 질리지가 않아서 좋습니다. 매번 매번 새로운 공연 하는 기분. 저는 관객분들도 당연히 신경을 쓰지만 사실 이제 위에서 세 명에서 하는 이 3인극이다 보니까 매번 할 때마다 새로운 공연을 하고 있는 그런 기분. 그래가지고 이제 안 질려서 좋아요. 네, 원래 한 네 달 되면은 대부분 이제 이 머신이 되잖아요, 기계가. 근데 전혀 그런 게 없이 항상 좀 긴장되고
지금도 떨리고
다르게 주시면 맞아. 또 다르게 갈 수 있는 그런 매력.
긴장이 많이 되죠.
네.
엄청 긴장이 아이콘.
특히 사랑비를 타고는 약간 관객들이랑 같이 하는 게 좀 있잖아요.
예, 맞아요,
그죠?
맞아요.
아직도 있으시죠? 형들 예, 막 즐거운 동생들
파티, 생일 축하.
즐거운 파티도 하고 있어서. 막 수건 갖다가 네. 막 네. 이런 것도 하고 그러니까 그러니까 그런 게 진짜 매력적인 것 같아요.
The small but cozy theater is also the birthplace of world stars.
The activity in the smaller theaters is directly related to what's going on in the larger theaters. I've been here now 10 years, and many of the actors that are now stars, I saw in smaller theaters and put into our productions, and their careers can develop that way. Also, people who started writing smaller shows there have had major now productions. Korean artists have written productions that have made it to the big theaters. Everything's united. Everything is a part of the same artistic puzzle here.
At small theaters, the actors often have to take care of everything themselves, from costumes and makeup to props. Of course, just because the theater is small does not mean that they don't get nervous. The young actors who are destined to become stars get closer and closer to their dream. Having watched a musical imbued with Sohyang's memories, Robert sets out to show her a performance that made a huge impression on him. A rehearsal is in full swing. Unlike a typical musical, however, there are neither songs nor dialogue. Still, the two watch on eagerly.
Hi. Nice to
meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Yeah. Thank you so much for having us.
Welcome to my theater.
Oh, thank you.
Come here.
Okay, I'm a big fan of Jump.
Wow.
I've been here many times. Oh. I brought many friends. I brought my nephew from America who does taekwondo.
Wow.
He laughed his head off. He was like, oh my God.
Wow.
You know, right?
Thank you.
Can you tell me what is the history of Jump?
처음에는 넘버벌이라는 무언어 연극을 하다가 저희가 아크로바틱과 대한민국을 대표하는 뭐 태권, 태권도, 그리고 중국 무예인 우슈, 쿵푸 이런 거 취권 등을 넣어서 저희가 어떻게 하면 익스트림한 공연을 만들 수 있을까 해가지고 시작되게 됐습니다.
So how many times has Jump been performed outside of Korea? And how did audiences around the world respond to it?
점프는 해외에서 한 2000여 회를 했고요. 뉴욕 브로드웨이에서도 했었고 그리고 영국 웨스트엔드에서도 했었고 그리고 영국에 있는 유명한 피콕 극장에서도 저희가 공연을 했었고요. 굉장히 좋아하세요. 그래가지고 팬들도 굉장히 많이 생기시고 뭐 호주에서 한글을 직접 배워서 편지도 써주시는 분들도 계시고 네.
So as a director, how is it different to direct Jump as opposed to a play or a musical?
일단 뮤지컬이다 연극은 어떻게 보면은 짜여진 동선 안에서 그리고 노래 안에서 그리고 대사 안에서 이루어지는데 저희는 일단은 배우들의 표정으로 그거를 다 표현하기 때문에 저 친구들한테 보일 수 있는 색깔 그런 색깔을 많이 해서 저희가 넘버벌 공연을 만들고 있습니다.
I'm very honored to actually get to see a rehearsal because I can't even imagine how you rehearse a show like this. So, could we see a little bit?
Oh, good.
All right.
Yay.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Here, you stand in front of me.
You must be quite careful when watching Jump, for you never know when a kick might come your way.
Oh, my God.
I'm afraid to shake your hand. I'm afraid. Oh my. Hi, everybody. It's so good to see you. Thank you. Thank you for doing this.
Oh,
All the actors in Jump are martial artists. To perfect these highly advanced moves, they practice again and again.
점프는 기승전결이 참 탄탄하게 돼 있어서 관객들이 참 그래서 좋아하시는 것 같아요. 그걸 또 저희가 몸으로 그 스토리를 표현하고 그 대사와 노래가 아닌 저희가 효과음으로만 저희가 표현을 했기 때문에 참 참신하다? 그래서 아직까지도 관객들이 사랑해 주시는 것 같고 세계의 모든 팬들이 저희를 사랑하진 않을까 생각이 듭니다.
In the non-verbal performance Jump, actors perform difficult action scenes that are usually created with the use of wires or clever camera tricks. These novel attempts made by Jump will open new doors for stage performances. Afternoon arrives. And Robert is at the rehearsal for Monte Cristo, the musical that he is directing. His usual smile is gone, replaced by a serious look. Telling the vengeful story of the Count of Monte Cristo, who was unfairly locked up for 14 years, the musical features a lot of action scenes.
난 정관이 이거 없이 사람을 죽인 적이 없고.
The musical's martial arts director had actually been involved in the production of Jump. The meeting between the director, the martial arts director, and the actors lasts for hours, all of them intent on staging lively and dynamic scenes for the audience. Watching the actors, Robert is reminded of Jump.
So when Jacopo slices the three guys, they lean back and then come back up together.
One, two, three, four.
Yeah, right, and then go back. Right. And then all come up together. Okay, and when Albert gets both bones, when he gets the two bones, if he will do longer, with the bones. Yeah, so we can get a laugh out of it. Okay, in the slow motion part of the fight, you know, what I'd like it to start right when he gets hit, you know, so like he gets hit regular time and then goes into the slow motion. Is that possible? Yeah, right. That's right. Yeah, and then everybody goes slow motion. Yeah, right, exactly, do all the reactions. All right. That's how it was, you know, when I saw Jump. You know, I saw Jump several times. It's so funny. But you were in Jump. Yeah, right. How long were you with Jump? So a lot of what we're doing in the fights in Monte Cristo are things you learned when you were doing Jump? I mean, you learned about all the fighting at that time?
액션적인 거는 어쨌든 합격인 거는 다 거기 이게 비슷비슷한 맥락이 있기 때문에 그거는 점프를 하면서 많은 도움이 됐고 동작을 짜면서도 그때 배웠던 것들도 너무 많아서 많이 협조가 이렇게 되면서 지금 우리 무술 조감독 하는 사람도 점프 배우였었고 지금 작곡파 하는 친구도 점프를 했던 사람이라서 그래서 커뮤니케이션이 많이 돼요.
The action scenes he saw in Jump are reflected in his work. It's as if the missing piece of a puzzle has finally found its place.
Since this is the last run through, we're going to see, even though you're going to be here for one more, we really have a good team. Everybody. Our whole team is wonderful. And we're going to have a really great show. So the most important thing now is just to enjoy performing and have fun. Just have a good time. You have a lot more things to worry about when we get in the theater. So for the next two, for tonight, today and tonight, really have a good time and just enjoy each other. And let the joy come through.
Moved by Robert's words of encouragement, they all gather around and put their hands together.
자, 가자.
Ready? Just say it. Yeah. 자, 가자.
Monte Cristo, Shabalo!
The musical Monte Cristo finally lights up the stage. Despite his long career as a musical director, his works never get tried. The secret to his success lies in his unique sense of mise-en-scène, with which he ceaselessly creates new things. The autumn scenery is a healing sight.
I did have a good time. I like this park. I come here a lot. It refreshes me because it's so close to rehearsal. Mm-hmm. And I can clear my head. I can, you know, it's great to be around nature. This is very beautiful. The trees are, and there's always the music so we can dance, you know. And we're going down the street like this.
I love that.
That's fun, huh? It's very delicate. Mm-hmm. Wow. It's a beautiful color. It's so pale. Mm. Oh, that's nice. I feel very calm.
Do you like tea?
I love tea. I have all kinds of tea. I love tea, but I've never had this tea. Oh, this but I'm going to drink the whole bowl, so I'll be very calm.
Can I drink like this?
For you and I, we have a similarity because we both work in Korea and we both work in America.
Yes.
And so we see firsthand the similarities and the differences.
I really wonder, what's the hardest part of directing in Korea?
Well, of course, the language barrier. Mm. You know, I have translators for everything.
Right.
And I wish I could understand every word that's being said. I mean, I come to understand it because I have a back translation. I know what all the words mean. Mm. But the most important thing is that the emotion is honest and true. Mm. And you can tell whether it's in the language or not.
Right.
You know, it's somewhat like when you direct opera,
mm-hmm.
you know, in foreign languages. But of course, in opera, the music is all, the emotion
right.
is written into the music. With musical theater, you have music and you have
right.
drama, you have scenes, you have acting. So, and the emotional line has got to be true. So if it feels false to me, then I question it.
Mm.
I say, what is exactly you're saying here? And is this the emotion that's behind this? You know, and you get into those kind of discussions
mm-hmm.
and eventually you find your way and it all, you know, works out. Because
yeah.
one of the things that I love about Korea is the talent of the actors. The talent is phenomenal. It's great talent, not
actually,
only in
yeah,
acting,
really
but really in singing.
Yeah.
You know, I'm going to be frank. I mean, I think the greatest singers in all of Asia are right here.
Mm.
I mean, everybody comes from the other countries, from Japan and China, to see musicals
mm.
here in Korea. It's just a secret outside of Korea to the Western world, you know. You know, they know K-pop, but they don't know how extraordinary the actual musicals are, because all that musical talent is in the musicals, too.
Enjoying a sincere conversation and a warm cup of tea, the two promise to go on another trip together. Today they are on their way to a city where even the trees have their own expressions. It's Goryeong of Gyeongsangnam-do Province.
I'm really glad we got to come here in the autumn.
I know.
It's nice to get out of Seoul and see the changing of the leaves.
It's warmer down here.
It's much warmer.
Yeah.
So all the leaves haven't really turned so much yet because it hasn't been cold enough, but these
exactly.
trees here, they've already turned. Look at them.
You're
They're
so
actually
pretty.
Falling off. I've been here in every season now. Yeah, it's great.
They are here to look at tal, or Korean masks.
Thank you.
Robert is immediately gripped by the masks and the diverse expressions they show.
You know, what's interesting is this is very like modern art. You know, like we see in the early 20th century, Dolly or something, it has a real unusual, you know, composition with the silver around the eyes and everything. It's very interesting.
There is a special reason why Robert wanted to look at these traditional Korean masks.
Well, the musical that we're doing, Phantom, the Phantom in this story always wears different masks to show his feelings and his emotions. And so whether he's angry, whether he's sad, whether he's celebrating, whatever those things are. And what I find when I see all of these various masks from Korea is that they represent many different emotions. Immediately when you see the color or you see the expression on the face, you know that it's expressing some inner feeling very dynamically in a very large way. And that's what we were trying to do with these masks in Phantom as well. So the minute the audience sees it, they know, oh, this is how he's feeling in this moment. So it's very interesting to see how similar those two ideas are.
The two decide to meet a master of mask craft.
Ah, look who's here. 안녕하세요. It's so nice to meet you.
Yeah.
I like your hair. I have to grow my beard longer now to do my beard. Could you show us your mask?
Yeah, I'll see.
Great, thank you.
This is the workshop where he has been making masks for decades.
Oh my gosh. This is incredible.
The ceiling is packed with hundreds of unique faces.
I see. No, I understand. I know. I see. That you feel like you just go, your mind, you go into the wood. You're in the wood and the wood is talking to you. The wood is telling you. You know, it's sort of as though the mind and the wood becomes one.
Among his large collection, the master has his
favorite.
I know, it's very bright. It's very happy. It's hard to say anything is a favorite because everything is wonderful, but these really are very special. They all have a very special feeling. You can feel it out of each one so strongly.
In the Western world, masks are used to hide oneself, but the Korean masks are used to express one's individuality. This discovery of cultural difference brings an artistic inspiration to Robert.
One of my major inspirations for doing musicals is traveling, because so many musicals take place in so many different locations around the world. The ones we're doing right now take place in Paris or in France or on this strange island in the middle of the Mediterranean. And so I've traveled all my life, and I find it, first of all, thrilling, and I find it's very, very inspiring to not only travel to the places your story is about, but anywhere you travel, you learn about the people, you learn about the things that make us different and the things that make us very similar.
We hope that this journey with Robert was a meaningful experience for Sohyang as well. After his short trip with Sohyang, Robert has returned to his everyday life. This is the rehearsal for the musical Phantom. In this musical, the most important props are, naturally, the masks worn by Phantom. Hiding Phantom's hideous face, different masks are used to express his emotions. Robert decides to inspect the masks more closely today.
Okay, let's take a look at the masks. The thing, you know, that makes our show Phantom different from the Phantom of the Opera is that the Phantom wears so many different kinds of masks to show his different emotions. So I'd like to check with you today, since now all the masks are finished, and we'll look them over and see if we think they're okay.
예, 좋습니다.
This is the mask that's most like what people identify with the Phantom, and yet we've made it a little bit different. We also wanted to create an asymmetry because it actually makes it look somehow more tragic. You know, it's not just a plain like Halloween mask. I think, and this looks very good on the face. Now I'm really happy with this one. It's great. So this is one of my favorites because when he accidentally kills someone, he's feeling remorse and he's sad. It's very tragic. And this one looks very good on stage because of the sense of being like a clown mask, but yet has the tears. So that they can just put it on stage and it just slips right on and it sits there, making it easy to go on. And actually, it's very light. It's actually very comfortable. Okay, this mask for this season, we made it not as red as it was before, but now when I see it on stage, in the rehearsal, we haven't yet seen it under the stage light. When I see it in rehearsal, I'm afraid it might read too dark. I think that we may have to pull out the red colors more and make it feel more hot, more angry, more read better to the audience. What's nice is when he changes his mask, he takes his mask off and then he puts a new one on and he turns around with the mask on his face and then we see the new emotion. So it's very effective. I think people are surprised when they see this mask.
His take on masks has changed a bit. He now wants the masks to not just hide Phantom's face, but also show his expressions and his personalities, just like Korean traditional masks. The masks will play an even more important role in the performance. Robert's last destination is Gongju, Chungcheongnam-do Province. Once the capital city of a kingdom, it still has traces of the tradition and history from the past. Today, Robert's accompanied by a 10-year-old travel buddy. He is Kwak Ian, a child actor starring in the musical Phantom. Playing the role of Phantom when he was a child, Ian's emotional acting is as mature as that of an adult actor. When Ian has some concerns, Robert is the first person he turns to.
이 팬텀의 극 자체가 파리에서 시작되는 거잖아요, 프랑스. 근데 프랑스 아이들의 모습들을 연기하려고 하니까 좀 어려운 부분이 있는 것 같아요.
Well, you know, Ian, 네. You've been actually doing shows with me since you were 5, and now you're 10 years old,
네.
And you've grown and grown and grown with every show.
Yes.
So it's always good to read about it and learn about that time that you're acting in and how people behaved at that time in their lives, you know, in a history. But you actually are conveying, I'm very proud of the way you're working because you really have a great focus, which is really important. You have to be very focused in your intention and really think about what you have to do when it's a dramatic musical. And of course you have very emotional scenes where you have to cry, and so you have to find inside of you the reason to cry and make it believable to the audience, which you do very well. I'm very happy with how you're doing it. You just always have to every night remember to put yourself in that honest spot and really make it fresh for the audience every night, and I'm very proud of the way you're doing that.
Robert's sincere advice will boost the young actor's confidence and prepare him for the big show. The two build a friendship that closes the decades between them.
I'm going to go to the Pansori school today. That'll be interesting. I think you're going to get a singing lesson. It'll be interesting to see what happens.
You're a phantom, I am Christy.
Yes, that's right, that's right.
Ian's biggest strength is his clear, ringing voice. Today, Robert is about to present him with a novel experience. Thank you so much for that performance. Tell me, what is the story of the song that they were singing?
아, 지금 우리 아기들이 불렀던 곡은요. 춘향가 중에서 이별 대목인데 이도령이 어떻게 이 이별 사실을 춘향이한테 이야기할까? 고민하면서 지금 춘향이 집을 향해서 걸어가면서 굉장히 슬픈 마음으로 춘향이 집을 가고 있는 그 내용을 소리로 한 것입니다.
I see. Well, what exactly is pansori and what makes it different from other musical genres?
판소리는 이 반주, 북치는 드럼 치는 사람 반주자 한 명에 또 소리하는 사람이 한 사람이 손에 부채를 들고 노래와 또 이야기와 또 이 발림, 움직이는 동작, 무용까지 곁들여서 긴 시간을 소리하는 것을 판을 긴 이야기를 판을 짜가면서 소리한다고 그래서 판소리라고 하고요. 판소리가 다른 음악과 다른 점은 일단 발성도 다르지만 관중하고 소통할 수 있다는 거. 그러니까 다른 음악은 조용히 이렇게 듣고 이따 일어나서 이제 기립박수 치고 좀 판소리 할 때는 쉼새라는 게 있는데 객석에서 얼씨구 어이 좋다 이렇게 객석에서 호응을 해줘요. 그게 굉장히 좀 특이하게 다르다고 이제 할 수 있습니다.
In a pansori performance, the audience's participation is just as important as in madangnori. Traditional performing arts were perfected through seamless interaction between the audience and the actors.
Very good. Well, I'm really impressed with all of you. You're just incredible. Now, Ian has been learning Pansori for 1 hour.
Yeah.
But you've been learning it for quite a long time. So, can you give me a little example of some of the songs you sing? Wow, you have a beautiful voice, very powerful. That was great. 've had such a wonderful time on all the travels, and seeing all different parts of Korea has been illuminating and really special. I think the Pansori school was probably the most remarkable, to see those traditions carried on through children, you know, not just older people doing it, like an older tradition that's maybe fading out or dying, it's actually alive and well, with young children participating and being awarded and thrilled to grow through that medium. I think that was the most impressive for me. I think traveling with Ian is probably going to be something that will stick with him for a while. I think those experiences one has when one's young, like Ian has had, will stay with him. I think singing the Pansori songs will be a new dimension for him, and he'll see that there's all kinds of opportunities and things out there in the world.
Ian's acting carries a depth of emotions.
Get in here, get in here. Look, he still has his hair.
Who we got?
Another of Robert's works unfolds on stage. We hope that his travels in Korea will live on in his future works, giving birth to many masterpieces.